Hello everybody, my name is Rachel and welcome to my channel, Colonnati. Today I'm going to review Winterkeep by Kristin Cashore. Winterkeep is the fourth book in Cashore's young adult fantasy series called The Graceling Realm. The first three books are Graceling, Fire, and Bitter Blue, and I think that Winterkeep could be pretty accurately described as a direct sequel to the third book, Bitter Blue. It takes place about 4 years after the events of that book, and Bitter Blue remains one of the primary characters, and the future of her kingdom, Monsea, is kind of in the balance in this book. So I think that all of the books in this series, including Winterkeep, have relatively self-contained plots, but it is difficult to review a later book in a series where there is a long history of the characters and their relationships, and it's all connected by a series of chronological events. So I'm going to talk about things that are just in Winterkeep, and I'm not going to try to dive into explaining the world building and past events and things like that. If this book sounds good to you, you should just absolutely read the entire series. So with that, let's talk about this book. When Winterkeep begins, it's quickly established that the kingdoms of the Graceling Realm have now come into contact with a new continent called Torla. The nations of Torla, including one called Winterkeep, are not monarchies. They seem to be more like republics, and they have a lot of technology, including cool things like airships. They don't seem to have a lot of magic. They don't seem to have gracelings, which are people who have magical gifts, but they do have telepathic silver cows, which live in the sea, and blue foxes that bond with people. Bitter Blue is the queen of Monsea, and she discovers that Winterkeep importers have been essentially stealing her kingdom's resources by taking advantage of her own ignorance about the value of those resources. In addition, two of her close advisors and friends died in a mysterious ship accident in Winterkeep a year ago. Only now, Bitter Blue has begun to suspect that it wasn't an accident and they were killed on purpose to keep something from her. And then it comes to light that another of her friends and her former lover, a man named Katu, is also mysteriously absent, and his relatives, the Kavendas, are one of the families that have been taking advantage of Monsea. Bitter Blue decides to go to Winterkeep herself to deal with these problems face to face. She is accompanied by her secret half-sister, Hava, and her loyal friend, Gideon. Hava is a graceling with the ability to change what people see when they look at her. Gideon is a disowned lord from one of the other graceling realm kingdoms. He is definitely in love with Bitter Blue, and he works for the council, mainly helping gracelings escape persecution to Monsea. His role in the story makes a lot more sense if you've read the previous books. So Bitter Blue and Gideon are two of the primary point of views in the story, and there are three others from the Winterkeep side. One is another primary perspective, that is Lovisa Kavenda. She is the niece of Katu, and her parents, Benny and Ferla, are two very important politicians in Winterkeep, and she suspects that they are doing something terrible, and she needs to find out what it is. Then the other two Winterkeep perspectives are more interstitial. They pop up every once in a while. One is a blue fox named Adventure who is bonded to Ferla, that is Lovisa's mother. And the other is very interesting. It's the Keeper, who is this like kraken or squid-like creature, the focus of many of the myths and legends of Winterkeep. And the Keeper's secrets are things that humans probably need to know to solve a lot of the mysteries in this book. This is a very complex summary that leaves out some interesting details. For me, much of this plot boiled down to two things that I was very interested in: Bitter Blue and Gideon's relationship and their realization of how they actually feel about each other, and then Lovisa coming to understand that she is the victim of her parents' abuse and what all of that means. And these two things play out against this really rich backdrop of political intrigue, environmental issues, the misuse of natural resources, and of course, magic. I really enjoyed the topics and the themes of this book. It's very political and it has this streak of environmentalism in it that I wasn't expecting. In fact, I think the book really shows how political concerns conflict with environmental issues, especially when you're talking about legalizing the use of a natural resource that can pollute the environment and kill indiscriminately while enriching only a few. For people who have read the previous books, there's also the return of some themes that are immediately recognizable and that I think really make this book and like the series overall stand out. And those include things like mental manipulation and mind control, the journey to recover after trauma, and then resilience, or this thing that Bitter Blue says repeatedly in this book, being stronger than the way others make you feel. At this point, I do want to mention that there are definitely content warnings for this book. I would point out child abuse, starvation, and sex, and it's actually the sexual content that I want to talk about more in just a second. This book was frankly amazing. I wish that I could speak more to how the books in the series have evolved, but it's been such a long time since I read the first three, I can't really compare them. I do think that this series tackles more difficult, darker subject matter, and I found all of the books, in particular Bitter Blue and Winterkeep, to be very emotional. They just really grab me and make me care about what is happening to the characters. So for me, Winterkeep hit just the right spot. It really clicked with me at a certain point when I understood what was going on with Lovisa. At first, I didn't like her. I found her very unlikable, sneaky, cunning, manipulative, eavesdropping on people, and I was worried that I wouldn't really get into the story because I just didn't sympathize with her, and she's a big part of this book. And then she starts using like sex as a tool to manipulate people and situations, and she's a teenager, she's like 16 years old, and it was really uncomfortable. And then I got to thinking about it a little bit more, about why the sexual content is in this book. Lovisa is the victim of emotional and physical abuse, and I think the way that sex is used in this book is to show basically healthy versus unhealthy ways of connecting with people. Lovisa uses sex and sees people in relationships in a really toxic way because that's kind of what she's been taught. And how she approaches sexual encounters says a lot about how she views herself, her body, her own worth, and it shows how like emotionally disconnected she is from other people. The way that she thinks about and processes her sexual encounters and the way that she reacts to seeing other people together changes a bit throughout the course of the book as she realizes the bad things that have been done to her. And I think it was actually very realistic and well done. I think that it may be very easy to view the sexual content in this book at kind of a surface level and miss that it's actually a sign of deeper psychological problems, perhaps. So it has its place in the book, but I can see where other readers might think it's just not a good idea to have that sort of thing in a young adult novel. But like I said before, Cashore has definitely gone into more difficult subject matter in these books before, and its inclusion here didn't surprise me that much. I loved this book. I think Winterkeep is pretty brilliant. It is definitely another outstanding installment in this series. And for people who might be worried that it's like a cash grab, you know, author returning after many years to a previously popular series, that usually carries with it some bad connotations, but it's definitely not the case with this book. It is worth reading. It's just as strong as the previous books, and I think it has some really important things to say about a number of issues that are relevant to readers today. And I think overall, this book, the whole series, it's so rich. It's so well written, but where all of these books shine, where Winterkeep shines, is in the characters, in their relationships, and in how so many of them are trying to do better, to improve, to recover, and to heal. And I think that that's a message that never gets old. We all need to hear that. This book is a must-read, in my opinion. If you have read the previous books in the Graceling Realm series, you should definitely get onto this one. And if this book sounds interesting but you haven't read the previous books, just read the whole series. It will be worth it, I promise. So do let me know if you have read Winterkeep. What are your opinions on it? Leave me a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be back to talk to you again soon. And until then, bye.